Hi, let's talk about the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. The nasal cavity is an irregular space bounded by the hard and soft palate as the floor, the frontal and ethmoidal and sphenoidal bones as the roof, which is separated from the nasopharynx by the choana, and communicates with the external environment through the nares, which feed into the nasal vestibule. The medial wall of the nasal cavity is the nasal septum, which has been removed here in this sagittally sectioned specimen. And the lateral wall consists of conchae, or nasal turbinates, which provide turbulence to the inspired or inhaled air, which brings as much of this air into contact with the mucosa of the nasal cavity so that it may be warmed and moistened and can capture any impurities before they enter the respiratory system. The roof of the nasal cavity has olfactory epithelia, so embedded within that epithelium are the ends for the olfactory nerves, cranial nerve 1, so that olfaction is possible. Now, when we look at these nasal conchae, we see that there are three. There is a superior, a middle, and an inferior nasal concha. The superior two are of the ethmoid bone, and we sometimes refer to them as ethmoturbinals. The inferior is its own separate bone. So looking here at the skull, in the anterior view, we can see the inferior and the middle conchae. We cannot see the superior from this view. Now the spaces which are surrounded by the nasal conchae are known as meatuses. A meatus is a tube-like space or opening. And I just want to turn your attention here to the anterior view of the skull. We can see how these conchae scroll. And so this space, or these spaces, which exist within the scrolled bone that are invested by mucosa, are the meatuses. So superiorly here, between the superior concha and the sphenoid bone and the remainder of this, the roof of the nasal cavity, which is the ethmoid, is the sphenoethmoidal recess. The space which is inferior to the superior concha, and granted we can't see much of this because it scrolls around, is the superior nasal meatus. The space which is inferior to the middle nasal concha is the middle nasal meatus, and the space which is inferior to the inferior nasal concha is the inferior nasal meatus. Now the nasal cavity is going to communicate with the paranasal sinuses, those hollow or cancellous spaces within the bones that are surrounding and forming the nasal cavity. And so different meatuses and the recess will communicate with these different cavities. In order to see these communications, we need to remove the conchae or perform what would be known as a turbinectomy, the removal of a turbinate. So we're looking at the lateral wall of the nasal cavity here with the turbinates removed. So someone has come through and they have removed the superior, they have removed the middle, and they have removed the inferior turbinate, so that we can see the lateral walls more clearly so that we can see the contents of these meatuses. In addition here, someone has added colored wire to demonstrate some of the communications that we can see between these recesses and meatuses with the paranasal sinuses that they are going to serve. So starting here, this would be within the sphenoethmoidal recess. We have a communication with the sphenoidal sinus to the posterior. So that red is the pathway to the sphenoidal sinus from the sphenoethmoidal recess. Within the superior nasal meatus, we have a communication to the posterior ethmoidal air cells. And we can see some of those there and some there as well. Those air cells in total are going to comprise the ethmoidal sinus. So there isn't one large ethmoidal sinus, but there are collections of air cells. So we'll see posterior ethmoidal air cells, middle ethmoidal air cells, and anterior ethmoidal air cells, and some of their communications. We can also see the communication to the frontal sinus here. That's going to be within the middle nasal meatus and the maxillary sinus there. But we'll discuss those on the next slide when we discuss the middle nasal meatus. The final communication that I want to point out to you here is the opening for the nasolacrimal duct. So the nasolacrimal duct, if you recall, is the passageway through which tears are drained from the medial canthus or angle of the eye into the nasal cavity. And they specifically drain into this inferior nasal meatus via that nasolacrimal duct. So now let's take a look at the middle nasal meatus. This is probably one of the busiest regions of the lateral wall. And one of the more conspicuous features that we can see is this ethmoidal bulla, this large outpouching of bone. The ethmoidal bulla is the creation of the middle ethmoidal air cells. And upon the bulla, we can see the openings to these air cells. Antero-inferior and inferior to the bulla, let me erase this so that I can best highlight it, we have an opening. This opening anteriorly here is known as the ethmoidal infundibulum. So that's a funnel-like passage, and that's where the opening of the frontonasal duct is going to be. As we move posteriorly from that, we have what's known as the semilunar hiatus. And that semilunar hiatus is going to contain two sets of openings. So in between the infundibulum and what comes next will be the openings for the anterior air cells. And then as we move posteriorly, we'll have the opening of the maxillary sinus. So infundibulum with the opening for the frontonasal duct. Then as we move posteriorly and inferiorly, the opening for the anterior air cells, and then the maxillary sinus. So if the anterior air cells are here, and the middle air cells are here, the posterior air cells are there. So we can see approximately the locations of these air cells and how they might relate to the nasal cavity. Thank you very much for your time.